Hello, hello, it's Asia Marke here, Lemon Creation, and today I have a project for you which I made for Lindiskank using their products and a new embossing powder which is really, really beautiful. You can see it right here. And the theme, well, San Valentine, a little bit romantic. So guys, I don't have a perfect setup. You can see my light here, which is reflecting in the plexiglass I put on my bureau. Because I just shifted houses and I am still working on the proper setup, so sorry for the reflection, you can see that. And I was showing you, I have a jelly plate, my very first one I bought, because I earlier I used the homemade, which was working fine also. And two sprays, Tea Pot Purple and Raspberry Lemonade, one is Starburst, one is Flat, and Cagni with Spoon Grey, so actually three sprays from Lindy's. And beside, you can see the regular printer paper. So, as I was saying, I used to have a homemade jelly plate, which was working fine, but I have to tell you that I could not remove the paints afterward. It was quite hard. From this jelly plate, the paints are coming off very, very easily. So I just spray them. I am placing the paper now, and with the brayer, I'm just printing it on the paper. It's very straightforward. I did not work too hard, to be honest, because well, the reason is that they are sprays after all. They are not acrylics, so well, you cannot do everything with the jelly printing as you could do with acrylics, because they're gonna behave differently, quite simply because they are sprays. If you use squirts, Lindy's squirts, they are not gonna flow as easily as sprays, so it's gonna, maybe the effect is gonna be even better. But as you can see, I managed also to make some print with the stencil. This is more tricky once again with the sprays than it would have been with acrylics, but my point here is to show you that with Lindy's you can do almost everything you want. The effects will be just different. If you want to have something perfect, like a very perfect print, of course it's better to use acrylics, but otherwise this print is quite nice. So as you've seen, I just sprayed it over the stencil from the Crafter's Workshop, and then the rest of the paint I had on the stencil I just pressed on the paper once again, so I got this black print. And now I decided to use to add some pink over the black, and look at that, guys. For me, this is perfection. I like the distress look, so I'm really, really happy with that. And I'm gonna tear the pieces of it, because I just wanted to use it as a sort of tissue paper. The paper is quite fragile and quite thin. Of course, you could use the tissue paper also and make an imprint on tissue paper, but while I have, I think, more control over the printing paper and I'm happy with it, and also is more easily accessible as my tissue paper is somewhere still in the boxes, completely unpacked. And I'm gonna use this frame from Snip Art. This is a 3D frame, and this paper element from AB Studio from the collection Paradise Lost. Oh, because as I said, the San Valentine is coming, so I just thought that I'm gonna do something more romantic, which I don't usually do. So why not? And as you've seen, I put the pieces of paper on two pages to just check which one I prefer, and finally I chose the one which is more pink and violet. And of course I need to add some stamping, some embossing. This time for embossing I'm gonna be using pigment ink patch from Docrafts and the beautiful stamps from Rubber Dance, Round in Circles. So this time I'm gonna just do some embossing, and I'm using completely new, absolutely gorgeous embossing powder from Lindy. That's Marvelous, and look at that chunky, guys, like or chunkiness. I really, really love that. The powder is just amazing. Anyway, Lindy's released a good few powders like that, chunky ones, and I had no opportunity nor time, more time than anything else, to do the swatches yet. I'll try to do them, But at the moment when I'm filming this movie, I actually didn't do it. So I choose one which is with pink effects because there are some pink flakes in it. And look at that. It's like a kind of goldish, but like a melted metal. I have no idea. I really, really love that. The next step would be to add some stamping. This time again, I'm doing some distress stamping, so I take some Florilège Design stamps and I stamp it with the Raspberry Lemonade sprays from Lindy's. And then I use some script stamp also to add some text, and then I will also use a regular and my favorite archival jet black. Now I'm gonna be working again with that marvelous embossing powder from Lindy's, the new one. And I have to tell you, because this powder has so many chunks, it's working much better on the bigger surface. As you can see, my chipboard is quite small and the stamps I used earlier to emboss it, they were quite small also. So the big chunkiness, which is there, sometimes is just, if it's not mixed very well in the bottle, if you don't shake it very well, it may just disappear, you kind of don't see it. So that's why I'm taking tweezers right now to add these beautiful pink flakes to the chipboard. Because, well, you know, you may not always get them where you want them. But that's the thing with the chunky embossing powders, no matter where are they from, that's the thing. They are chunky, not always you'll get the all the chunkiness in one place, if you know what I mean. So sometimes you have to cheat a little, but still you may cheat and then the effect is there, and as long as the effect is there, it's just perfect. So this is it. Beautiful, beautiful powder, and it really looks like melted metal. I really loved it. And I'm really looking forward to at least start doing the swatches of these beautiful embossing powders, the chunky ones, released by Lindy's not so long ago. Because they really look, when you open the box, it's just, they look so yummy. They have this texture. I really love something which is not just normal, something which is a little bit original, and that's what it is, and that's what I love. So check them out, they are already in the shop. I added before some splatter with the raspberry lemonade, and now I have this word fairy tale from Scrapinets this time, and I could have embossed it. But I wanted also to show you that squirts are super, super good to color the chipboards. They really color them quite well. They have the shine, of course, to it. And that's what I got. So I'm happy with it. And I glue everything with the tacky glue because they are kind of chipboards and paper elements. So tacky glue is just fine for that. The last accent will be a contour paint from Stamperia. This one is in silver. So I just scribble on the paper a little bit. And this is it for this Art Journal page. Thank you for staying and watching either on my channel or on Lindy's Gang channel. Please check the new products Lindy has released, because they are really, really beautiful. And this is it from me. I hope you'll have a great day, and I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye!